All right, my amazing artists, are you ready to put into practice what we've learned over these last several weeks? We are going to create a David Hockney inspired landscape that shows us all of the principles of design that we talked about. We're going to have depth with our road. It's going to appear as though it's going back into the space. We're going to have movement as well with that road. We're going to have unity with all of our shapes and pattern when we put our designs into our shapes. We're going to have balance because we're going to have a horizon line with the sky and land, and then a left and right side of our road. We are going to have contrast because we're going to use bright, bold colors and dark colors that contrast each other. We are going to have emphasis because our road is going to wind its way through the center of our paper and it's going to break up our landscape, and that's going to be our emphasis. And of course, we're going to have rhythm. We're going to have that beat to our work because we're going to have different layers of our landscape, and that's going to give us that sense of rhythm and movement and music in our art. So, are you ready to get started? For this assignment, you're going to need a pencil and some crayons or oil pastel. You want to use crayons or oil pastel because you can color really thickly and scratch into your picture. If you don't have crayons or oil pastel and you only have markers, then you're going to have to do yours a little bit differently, okay? And if you're using crayons and oil pastel, then you're going to need something to scratch into it with. And you can use any sharp tool. I have a paint tool here, but you could use a toothpick. You could use the back of a paintbrush. You could use a pencil, really anything with a point that you can push into the crayon. All right, let's get started. So the first step is to draw our horizon line. So the horizon line is what sort of breaks up the sky and the land. And we want to do this near the top of our paper. And we want our horizon line to look like a hilly background, okay? So we don't just want to do a straight line across. We want our line to kind of go up and down. So I'm going to start on one side of my paper, and I'm just going to go up and down, just kind of loosely like this, to look like a hilly background. Now, I want to put in where my road is going to go. So I want to start somewhere off to one side, and I'm going to put my road in, and it's going to go to the right and to the left. And then back to the right, and then back down to the bottom of my paper. So that's my focus. That's where I'm going to have my emphasis and my movement. Okay. Now I want this to show depth or perspective. So when you look at something that's far away, it actually appears to be smaller than something that's close. And you can test that out anywhere you are. You can just look around the room you're in, look at the opposite corner, and see how things look smaller than the things closer to you. So the same thing happens with the road. It should get bigger as it comes closer to you. So we're going to make it look skinnier as it's in the background. And then when it gets close to us, we're going to make it look bigger. So I'm going to draw this another line next to this one, but I'm going to make it get bigger. Okay. So I'm going to start really close to this one. I'm going to bring it around. And then as I bring it around, you see how I'm going wider and even wider and even wider. And when I get here, it's the widest part. Okay. The last step with our pencil is to divide our land into sections. Those are the sections we're going to color and add our scratch technique too. Okay. So you can do this however you like to. I'm going to add a few more of these type of lines. So it looks like I have layers of hills first. Just kind of divide this up like this. So I have two more layers. I'm going to do one more down here. Now I'm going to make lines that go diagonally. Like this, because when you look at his piece, he has these sections of land. Okay. So just make some areas where you make some lines that kind of go diagonally There's another one, and you can put them anywhere you want to. Maybe another one up here, and they can be skinny or wide, it doesn't matter. I'm actually going to do another one here to break that space up a little bit. And maybe one more right here. Okay. Now you can decide. His picture also has little trees. If you want to add something like that, you can. Just remember the trees should be smaller in the background and then larger as they get closer. I'm going to make just like a little bush kind of coming right here on the side of the road. And then maybe part of one coming this way. Okay, so I think that's pretty well divided. So I'm going to put my pencil down and now I'm going to pick up my crayons or my oil pastels. So if you have crayons or oil pastels, you're going to do some block coloring. What that means is you're going to color in these shapes, and each one is a different color, very thickly. So some of us color lightly like this. That's not going to work for this technique. You want to make sure you're coloring nice and thick. You see the difference? That's how this technique is going to work. Nice and thick. Just like this. And I'm going to do this whole section with my crayon or oil pastel very thickly. And then I'm going to choose another color to do the next section. And again, not light coloring like this. Nice and thick, and we're trying to hide the white space. We don't want really too much white. The sky is different. If you're not going to do this technique in the sky, you can have a little bit of white showing, but you really want to make sure for this landscape that it's nice and thick. And you're just going to fill in the rest of these shapes with nice, thick colors. Now, again, if you're using marker, you're going to do your technique a little bit differently. So marker, just color regularly, and then I'll explain how to do that. And then I want you to think about the color for your road. Now, your road, you can do a scratch technique to it if you want to, but I'm not going to. So I'm going to pick a color that's going to be nice and bright and stand out because I'm not going to scratch on my road. All right, let's take a few moments and color nice and thick.
When I was 6 years old, I broke my leg. I was running from my brother and his friends. And tasting the sweet perfume on the mountain grass I rolled down. I was younger then. Take me back to when I found my
Okay, once you have your solid colors down, now it's time to add our over color that we can scratch into. Now, black usually works best, but you can use any color that is darker than the color you have on your paper. So for instance, this yellow, I could cover with blue, I could cover with purple. Any of these colors would allow me to scratch through and see the color underneath. If I have a dark color like this dark purple, there's not a lot that I can cover with that. So that one is definitely going to have to be covered with black. Now I put a layer of white on my sky, and I'm actually going to cover that with blue so I can scratch some texture into the sky when I'm all done. The road I'm going to leave, I am not going to scratch my road, but you are welcome to cover your road too. So the same rules apply with the overcoat that you want to make it thick. And yes, the colors are going to change because you're putting two colors on top of each other. So the color of this top color is not going to exactly be the color of the crayon. So you can see my black is not quite all the way black. That pink is kind of showing through. But I want to make sure I have a nice thick layer of my color. And I'm going to do that for the whole thing. Again, any color will do, just make sure it's darker than the one underneath. I'm just going to do black for the most of mine. All right, go ahead and color with your second color. This is where the fun creative part comes in. You can kind of see your shapes and your colors underneath this color. No matter which color you use, you should be able to see a little bit under there. I want you to take whatever sharp thing you're using, your pencil, your toothpick, whatever it is, and I want you to start scratching in designs in those shapes. So you just take your sharp object and you scratch into that layer, and you can see the color underneath shows through. So if you had used red on top of this, you'd be seeing red, and then the orange would be showing through the red. Because I use black on mine, that's what I'm seeing. And you just do this all over your paper until it is covered with designs, just like that. You see? I can go in here and I can scratch into here, and this, you can see how it works when you have two different colors other than a black. And you can see the top color, and then you can see the color underneath. So in this case, I colored my sky white, and now I'm going in and I'm scratching into the blue, and the white is showing through. And that creates that contrast. So go ahead and scratch into your picture.
Bye.
All right, my amazing artist, once you've scratched your landscape, just check to make sure there's nothing else you want to add. I actually added another color on top of my road because I thought it started to look more like a river and I wanted to have a little flowy texture. And then I scratched into that a little bit. And then I also scratched my name into my picture. And that's it. You're ready to upload your artwork to the Google Classroom. If you're doing this in class with me, you can just show me in class and you don't have to upload unless you'd like to. You can also share this on the Padlet. I can't wait to see what you created.